You are listening to the audio production of How Creativity Rules the World, The Art and Business of Turning Your Ideas into Gold by Maria Brito, published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by the author. Introduction. Today, everything and everyone competes for our attention. We live in a world that constantly drowns all of our senses. It is not enough to do something well. It is necessary to stand out, to be different, to be creative. Mastering this skill will not only benefit your career, but also have a ripple effect in all you do. This book will teach you how to do that for life. Businesses need to get noticed. Marketers want to sell more. Artists long to create impact. Entrepreneurs look for ways to surprise and delight their customers with every new turn. But most people fail at these endeavors because they don't know how to. The good news is that you possess a never-ending and always renewable source you can use to make money, reinvent yourself, pivot your business, or create products or services that your clients will love and will keep them coming back. It's called creativity. No matter what the issue, you can discover ways that disrupt and shake, allow you to make noise and gain influence, get your practice noticed or your big idea materialized. Every breakthrough in every industry and field comes from people who used their creativity to think differently. Developing your unique ability to express your ideas while generating value to your clients, your audience, or the people you serve will take you far. Whether you are an entrepreneur, an artist, or an employee, your creativity will help you turn the mundane into the extraordinary. This is the most crucial skill to have on your path toward success. Creative people come up with solutions that are relevant and novel for today's world. For years, you've been told that to be like them, you had to come to this world with special God-given talent, that there is something inside these visionaries that sets them apart and which nobody else can emulate. However, that is not true. Nearly everything that you've been told about creativity is a lie. Don't believe the myth that creativity is only for the few chosen ones or that it is genetic. It's false to think that you either have it or you don't, that it can't be taught or learned. Trust me, you were not born with a deficit in your creative abilities. Whoever said only artists are creative or that only scientists, engineers, and tech people innovate was dead wrong. Creativity is not about arts and crafts and cutouts or technical wizardry. Creativity is about fostering specific habits, making associations, and standing behind the ideas that come out of them. The old adage, think outside the box, doesn't cut it anymore. The most creative people in the world have a bag of tricks that help them nurture and grow their best ideas. This book gives you timeless strategies and tools that have been used time and time again by people from all walks of life throughout history. Creativity also is not one single thing. It is an amalgamation of habits and mindsets, nurtured by will and design. Creativity is what allows artists and entrepreneurs to move, shake, invent, disrupt, and transition as often as needed to meet today's challenges and tomorrow's in our convoluted world where change is the only constant. The way to survive and thrive in this environment is by using our creativity to keep us relevant and ahead of the curve. What do Leonardo da Vinci, Elon Musk, and Shonda Rhimes have in common? They are creative entrepreneurs. Successful entrepreneurs and artists are very similar. They imagine radical new possibilities without constraints or limitations and depend on their creativity to achieve their goals. As you'll see from the examples in this book, they share every trait that sparks the genius of their creative minds, their most important resource, which allowed them to forge their unique paths. Many of the examples in this book point at brilliant and creative tech entrepreneurs, but it is a mistake to think that creativity and innovation can only spur out of people dedicated to technology or science. It is also a mistake to think that only artists can be creative. I once was a miserable corporate attorney working at a big law firm in New York City, confined by restrictive rules and surroundings. After much soul-searching, I left that well-paid and stable job to start my own business in a completely unrelated industry, with no connections, no clients, no previous training, and no formal education in the business of art. Had I not learned how to develop my own creativity, I wouldn't have made it this far. It's been 13 years of tremendous joy, entrepreneurial effort, and hard work, but mostly my ability to generate thousands of ideas and relentlessly pursue and execute the most original ones. In this book, you'll discover how to do all of the following. Turn your business around. Invent something new. Get unstuck. Adopt habits and teach your brain to see things that others miss. Make associations that you never thought about before. Materialize your best ideas. I know it can be done because I have not only been my own guinea pig, but also taught hundreds of others, executives, entrepreneurs, freelancers, managers, business owners, artists, and many more, in person and online, to do it. But you must put in the time needed to understand that creativity is a series of actions that bring about desired results. The operative word is action. Creativity eludes those who sit down and wait for it to come. Your ability to respond swiftly to changes and come up with novel ideas that can be realized will determine your long-term survival and success in any endeavor. Right after I quit my job as an attorney, I opened an art advisory company that helps people and companies acquire, curate, develop, and display art and gain the financial, emotional, and aesthetic value that comes from collecting. By slowly learning how to use my dormant creativity and disrupt models that existed before I entered the business, I later branched out into creative design, product design in collaboration with artists, app development, gallery exhibitions, consulting, online classes, content creation, and TV hosting. With novel ideas and a fresh point of view, I helped build the art collections of hip-hop moguls, Oscar and Emmy-winning actors, Grammy-winning musicians, CEOs of Fortune 500 companies, Broadway producers, world-renowned physicians, law firm partners, fashion designers, bankers, and many more. More important, in the past 13 years, I have had the opportunity to observe, befriend, interview, write about, and work in many different capacities with more than 450 contemporary artists, which allowed me to witness their creative process from start to finish. In working with many business people and entrepreneurs, I noticed that the most creative and innovative ones share with successful artists the same creative habits and patterns of behavior. Even science has proven that the creative process for people in areas as far apart as math, engineering, and the arts is the same. After examining 2,277 university students in Germany, researchers from Maastricht University and the University of South Australia concluded that creative thinking doesn't differ much across domains and disciplines. While it is true that CEOs, programmers, and artists create different kinds of work with diverse intentions and outcomes, the skills and attitudes they use to get there are very similar. You may have noticed that I haven't talked about talent. Talent is a complicated issue. I know plenty of successful contemporary artists with not that much artistic talent, but loads of innovative ideas that they can execute with the right team and the creative vision to achieve them. I also know many wealthy and accomplished entrepreneurs, Jacks and Jills of all trades, who are not particularly talented at one thing, that they surf their own never-ending wave of creative ideas, and they know with whom to associate to reach success. Of course, I am not saying that talent isn't needed. It is a wonderful thing, especially if you were born with it. But talent without creativity is like pedaling a tricycle down the information superhighway. It will take you only so far. Companies and organizations are aware of the importance of creativity in the workplace and beyond. Yet, they struggle with the unorthodox idea that creativity can be taught and learned. For example, IBM conducted a survey of more than 1,500 CEOs from 60 countries and 33 industries worldwide. 60% of those CEOs answer that successfully navigating our complex world requires creativity over other qualities such as rigor, management, discipline, or integrity. Creativity is the number one quality they look for when they are hiring people and also when deciding whom to keep employed. For many years, LinkedIn has been scanning the information shared in the network by roughly 660 million professionals, searching for the skills that were most in demand in relation to its supply. The number one in-demand skill turns out to be creativity. During the pandemic, the World Economic Forum called creativity the one skill that will future-proof you for the job market. Interestingly, Adobe also interviewed 5,000 adults in the United States, United Kingdom, Germany, France, and Japan, which showed that only one in four people believed they were living up to their creative potential, and four in 10 said that they didn't have the tools or access to the tools they needed to become creative. This creativity gap between what industries, companies, and societies are clamoring for and what people believe they can contribute is plain wrong. Everyone is and can be creative. The tools aren't hard to find or expensive to get. They already belong to each one of us. To reap the benefits that come with revitalizing your creativity, you need the presence of mind and openness of spirit to practice your creative skills. Knowing that you will be dealing with ambiguities and being willing to experiment will take you far. You will need to be original, distinct, and sometimes even radically different than you were. As you incorporate the habits and use the tools you learn here, you will be able to adjust to the inevitable changes that occur. Your shifts and reinventions will happen easily, almost organically, because your mind and intuition will alert you to the right time to do so. In this book, I draw from the fields of art, history, business, entrepreneurship, psychology, and neuroscience. But my day-to-day observations of artists over the past 13 years are key to finding the core of the creative process. Most of the artists I've worked with can't explain how they reach their creativity, but having observed them closely for over a decade, I've unearthed the patterns and categories that I present in these pages. You may have heard of some of the artists named in this book. Others may be completely new to you, but what's important is that I have distilled what I learned from them so that you too can achieve your optimal flow of creative ideas. Artists are some of the most creative people, not because they have a special set of superpowers, but because they aren't bound by content restrictions or subject matter rules. Even the biggest challenges with materials cannot stop them. Their job is to imagine other worlds and envision many possibilities. Their art doesn't have to conform to the limits of reality or societal conventions. I found the same characteristics in the most innovative and disruptive entrepreneurs. They see how far their ideas can get, and they push until they see them materialize. That is pure creative alchemy. In this book, I will show you how to access your ideas, how to materialize them, how to shift, and how to innovate in the same way that artists and entrepreneurs do. By weaving 600 years of art history with concrete examples of modern entrepreneurs in areas ranging from cosmetics to entertainment, as well as my own experiences and personal anecdotes, you will learn how to ignite your creative mind.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.